Good morning, students. In this video, I am going to give you a practical demonstration how to make program based on while loop. Our first program is write a program to input I number and check whether entered number is Armstrong or not. So our first program is write a program to input I number and check whether entered number is Armstrong or not. Armstrong number is a number that is equal to the sum of cubes of a digits. So dear students, Armstrong number is a number that is equal to the sum of cube of a digits. For example, 0, 1, 153, 370, 371 and 407 are Armstrong numbers. For example, 153 is an Armstrong number because if the sum of the cube of a digits, sum of the cube of the digits of the number if the sum of the cube of a digits is equal to that number, then such numbers are called Armstrong number. So 153, 370 and 371, 407 are the example of Armstrong number because sum of the cube of a digits is equal to that number. Now I am going to give you a practical demonstration how to make programs based on Armstrong number in Python. Now, click on option 5, choose option save as and save your program with any name. Now, click on option run and choose option run module. If you enter 153, then 153 is an Armstrong number because the sum of the cube of its digits is equal to that number. Now, again, click on option run and choose option run module. If we enter 370, then 370 is also Armstrong number because sum of the cube of its digits is equal to that number. If we enter number 371, 371 is also Armstrong number because the sum of the cube of its digits is equal to that number. Again, click on option run, choose option run module. If we enter 407, then 407 is also Armstrong number because the sum of the cube of its digits is equal to that number. Now click on option run and choose option run module. If we enter number 345, then 345 is not an Armstrong number because the sum of the cube of its digits is not equal to that number. So I hope that you understand the concept of Armstrong number very well. Now I am going to give you how this program is working. Suppose you enter number 153 so you input number 153, copy the value of variable a in variable x. Since the value of a is 153, therefore the value of variable x will 153. Initial value of s is 0 and now condition will check in while loop is 153 greater than 0. Since 153 is greater than 0, condition is true, the statement present in while loop will be executed one by one. First statement present in while loop is b equal to a percent 10. It means 153% 10. We will get last digit of that number in remainder. Since we are dividing the number 1 by 3 with number 10 and note down and noting remainder, we will get last digit of that number. So the value of b will become 3. S barabar s plus b into b into b is our second step. Since the value of initial value is 0 and the value of b is 3, so 3 into 3 into 3. Now the value of s will become 27. A equal to a double divide by t 10. It means 153 double divide by 10. It means the value of a will become 15. Again, condition will check in while loop. 15 greater than 0. Condition is true. B equal to a percent 10. Equal to 15% 10. It means the value of b will become 5. Now s barabar s plus b into b into b. It means value of s is 27 plus 5 into 5 into 5. Therefore, the value of s will become 152. A equal to a double divide by 10. Value of a is 15. Double divide by 10. It means the value of a will become 1. 1 greater than 0. Condition true. B equal to a percent 10. Equal means 1% 10. B equal to 1. S barabar s plus b into b into b. It means the latest value of s is 152 and the value of b is 1. 1 into 1 into 1. It means the value of s will become 153. A equal to a double divide by 10. It means 1 double divide by 10. It means the value of a is 0. Since 0 greater than 0, condition false. Now the condition is false in while loop. After completion of while loop execution, the value of A will become 0 and value of S is 153. Since the value of S and the value of X both are matching, value of S is 153 and value of X is 153. Since both values are matching, therefore 153 is a palindrome number, since the value of s is equal to x. S equal to x, it means here value of s is 153 and the value of x is 153. Therefore, 153 is a palindrome number because the value of variable x and variable of value s both are matching. If these values are not matching, then number will not be palindrome. So, you know what is palindrome number? A number whose sum of the cube of its digits is equal to that number is called palindrome number. So, I hope that you understand the concept of palindrome number very well. Thank you. Have a nice day.